Welcome guys to Rally Sweden on WRC 3. This is the second part of the championship. Let's get it underway. It's come to a, what is it? Well, there's a link down below before I say anything else. There's a link down below in the description for Monte Carlo. And for some reason it's put us in a super special stage for the first one here. I would check show you the championship standings, but that might give away a bit of the rally. But yeah, anyway, let's see what we can do for stage, well, the first stage, the super special stage. Yeah, let's see what we can do here. I don't know if we can win over Sebastian Ogier. Maybe we can, but it's going to be a close rally, this is. Well, I hope it's going to be a close rally, because close rallies are always entertaining, so... Okay, right, left, chicane. We're getting a lot of chicanes here in this sector. And at least we haven't hit a wall yet. I know I say that and we're going to hit a wall at some point, but... But yes, we will end up hitting a wall at some point, but I just hope not so soon, but yes, so I don't really know what to say. I'm just trying to focus on bringing this car round these final, well, round this stage and actually winning this stage, to be perfectly honest. So okay, we got some jumps in the car. Isn't looking good. We've lost his wing mirrors over that jump, but well, we're definitely trying to throw everything at it to win this stage, because a bad stage here will set you off bad on, you know, on over, get your words out, James, over the course of the rally. And of course we've had bad stages before, but I am Petter Solberg. I should not be allowed to have bad stages. I should be perfect because I'm driving as Petter Solberg, and I don't want to disappoint. And if he is watching, I don't want to crash his car driving as him. But yes, I don't think he will be watching, but you never know. Like I said in the last one, you never know. Over these jumps, or over a jump, okay, that's fine. We might as well just, well, we can't throw everything at it, you know, that we want to, you know, jump wise, but oh, we're only just ahead on Loeb. Loeb isn't winning. He wasn't even... He was a couple seconds behind, so... This particular stage... Or this particular course... Is... Well, going to be between me or Sebastian Ogier, should I say. But we're only just slightly ahead. This is going to be a close fight. This is a close one. I love these super specials for this reason only. That they are super close. Right three, come on. Another hairpin. At least the only damage we've had is going to has been on the jumps. And then as I say that, we make a mistake. I think that's cost us something big, but yeah, he's way ahead now. But then again, it will work itself out. There's his wing mirrors. Maybe we might pick them up next time we come around, but handbrake, yep. Oh, that's nice through there. Traditionally in Rally Sweden, I've gone well on these particular games. Sweden on the PS2 games never was a big thing for me. I was never that good at them, but on these games I was, and that was a big moment, a big moment there. I don't even know what else to say, because I just had to try and stop it from spinning there. Am I throwing this stage away? I hope I'm not. We've got a few jumps to go. Well, we've got a big jump here to do. He's going under, but I think he's going to win. I think it's Sebastian Ogier that's going to win. Yep, Ogier will win. We've done something which cost us the rally win there. You have been beaten by your opponent. Yeah, well, my opponent's better, isn't he? So, yeah, so we lose by just over a second in that stage. No, actually, no, just under a second, should I say. So, yeah, and I will see you guys for stage number two. Right, so here it is, the first stage. We've got 6 seconds to start. The first proper stage on... well, it's stage number two, but the first proper in Rally Sweden, so That was an interesting fight. That was a close, good fight between me and Ogier. I cost myself a mistake, cost it the win, but yeah, let's see what we can do in a proper stage. I'm liking the fact that it is quite wide. Oh, never mind, he said narrows. Anyway, but yeah, it's a, like I said, Sweden has been good to me on these games. I don't really know if it's going to continue to be good for me. But, yeah, WRC 2010, okay, yes. So, okay, no, I was happy about the fact we went quickest, but I wasn't happy about that mistake. But yeah, we're just under a second off the lead, only just under a second off the lead after the first stage. It seemed closer, it did, and my recording is jumping all over the place. But anyway, yeah, jump, that's good, another big jump. Oh, that's a big jump. It was risky, but you need to throw everything at it if you want to win a rally. We've seen from Monte Carlo you're going to have to sacrifice your car, and maybe we sacrificed our car a little too much by the looks of things. But yeah, can we win in Rally Sweden to take, well, his first win of the season? Not like that, we're not. Why didn't I slow down enough? I'm not listening to the co-driver, that's my problem. But yes, anyway. Into left four. Okay, I'll take that left four. Oh no, come on. At least win a rally before Ogier does. You know, this season, this is what I normally know Sweden as. You know, very tight. You know, like that, it's a difficult rally. Very difficult rally, Sweden. It's on snow, it's another slippery rally. Right 4 and 60 into left 4. I know that, into left 4 and then over a bump. Oh, on crest, okay, I thought it was a bump, but okay. But, yeah. Well, come on, we can't have lost that much time. We missed out on a podium in Monte Carlo. I'm not wanting to miss out on a podium here in Sweden. Maybe third time lucky in Mexico, but, yeah. You never know, we could actually pull it off and win every single rally from now to the end of the season. I don't think that's going to happen, but you never know. Oh, I'm glad we landed before we ended up in another snowbank. Finish, he says. So, yes, we're across the line. Fourth, so we have gained some time back. The car's not looking too good, but anyway, yeah, we have gained some time back. Ogier leads the rally outright by 3 seconds as we're in second position. This is 7 stages here today, so I will see you guys for stage number 3. Okay, guys, the bodywork's still beating up, but at least we're here on the line for this stage, so let's see if we can do better. We finished 4th, which is our car number 4. That's where we actually finished in Monte Carlo as well, by 2/1000ths of a second to Danny Sordo, who nabbed his podium for the Mini, well, the Mini Cooper's World, well, no, not the Cooper, it wasn't. Oh, was I saying the Cooper? It's the Countryman. You idiot, James. Why? I knew it was the Countryman. Why did I say Cooper? But anyway. Yes, so, I don't know what to say. Let's hope we can actually pull off an impressive victory here in this stage and fight back. Because Sebastian Ogier is dominating. Well, not dominating. He's leading the rally so far by 3 seconds. He has won the first 2 stages. Well, involuntarily, I've let him win the first 2 stages, but hopefully we can pull this one off and cause a big upset. But then again, Petter Solberg winning wouldn't really be an upset, would it? Because he does win he has won a lot of rallies in his career. So, but yes, let's hope we can add to that. To be fair, but that's definitely what we need. 1.5 seconds. I would prefer to be 10.5 seconds clear in this stage, but I don't think that's going to happen in 2 stages. I mean, 2 sectors, should I say. At least I got it slowed down for a junction this time. Left 4. Yes, yes. around these tight corners. They're always beautiful, these corners are in Sweden. She's trying to... Okay, 2.2, that's good, that's promising, that's promising. Jump, okay. Yes, I'm okay. I don't matter if the car's not, because I'm trying to... I'm sacrificing the car to try and win this rally. Because I desperately want to win a rally. We got the power stage in Monte Carlo, which puts us on 15 rather than 12. You know, points that is, so... Yeah, so now we're only 10 seconds... No, not 10. No, actually, no, we're not 10 points, because Loeb got some points as well, so... Anyway, yeah, it doesn't matter, but oh, we're 4 seconds ahead. So we're looking like, if we win this stage, we actually take the lead in the rally, and actually have a bit of a lead ourselves. So, but we're putting a marker down with this stage. I'm definitely sacrificing, you know, the car over, you know, over winning a stage, or winning the rally, but like I said, that's sometimes what you have to do. Left, right, chicane. That's nice through there. Beautiful. Made it. Oh, so it's the end of the stage already? Just under 3 minutes. We win the stage. That's his first stage win in Sweden. And we've won 3 stages this overall season. And 6 seconds ahead of Sebastian Ogier. Is there any drivers that have retired? No, we are all running. All 26 of us are running. It's a... Daniel Oliveira, I think, or Oliveira is rounding out the top 10, the Brazilian in the Mini. As we win that stage, and what's our lead now? 3 seconds, so we basically reversed it on Sebastian Ogier. Stage 4 coming up, see if we can increase our lead. Got the car fully repaired, so we're sacrificing it, but we're trying to win. It's a, well, and the car's beautiful looking already. I wish it was... Well, I wish I wouldn't need to smash it up, but, well, I wish I wouldn't smash it up, but anyway, yeah, after that fantastic stage 3, we won a stage, 1 stage before we did in Monte Carlo, so, that's always promising, and, yeah, drifting, tapping a barrier, or tapping a snowbank, it's not really a barrier, here in Sweden, I was going to say Monte Carlo, but, yeah, so we dominated, well, not dominating the rally, we dominated that stage. Stage number 3, third time lucky in Rally Sweden, we win, well, we won that one. And we're bouncing off everything through there, but we're only 2 thousandths behind the great Sebastian Ogier. Sebastian Loeb, should I say. He's a 9-time World Rally Champion, but it wasn't 9, I think, it wasn't 9 when they made this video, I don't think. No, not this video, when they made this game. Of course he was a 9-time champion when I made this video. But yeah, we're bouncing off everything again. That's not good. We've lost his mirrors. Can it widen up a little so I can have a bit of breathing room? I'm definitely going to have to get myself something to eat. Ah, 2 seconds behind. As I was thinking about food, we dropped seconds. Anyway, yeah, definitely going to need to get something to eat after recording this. And probably a drink, because my throat is starting to hurt a little, or tickle a little. I get a little sore. That's because I've been recording a few videos as well. So, oh, look at that. We gained time on Sebastian Loeb there. The two Citroëns. Aha, he's a jump. Let's go over. Oh, okay, so what's the car front of the car look like? I don't want to look. Oh, I do. It's not too bad, but it'd be helpful if we get out that ditch. Don't cut. Okay, that's... Can just go flat through there. There we go. That's nice through there. Okay, so it's fantastic. I'm loving this so far. We win it. What is the difficulty actually on? I hope it's on something where it's challenging. Well, it is challenging. Yeah. Definitely dominating this. We're definitely in a groove now. It's. I think it's a little too wide, I think, to be perfectly honest. This rally in Sweden, it's not really that punishing. I can just take some of these corners. It's not as punishing rally as it has been on previous games. Even though this game, well, is about 4 years old now, but you know, we're across the line for 2 wins in a row. We win two stages in a row. That's, I tally up to four stage wins now. 4 seconds ahead of Loeb. As I said, we was dominating this rally. We are dominating this rally. Three stages to go and we are nearly 10 seconds ahead of Sebastian Ogier and 15 ahead of the great Sebastian Loeb. Right, so here it is, stage number 5. We got two to go after this one, or three including this one, and we are, looks like we are going to, you know, have a comfortable victory here in Rally Sweden. It seems a little too easy here in Sweden. Oh, it just seems a little too easy, full stop, as we're sliding through there. I don't know why it seems too easy, but we didn't win this stage, did we, when we first raced on it, you know, for stage number 2, but it might be different this time if we can keep off these snowbanks. But yeah, would you guys, actually, I know I'm, actually, I keep trying to put more series on for some reason on the channel, but actually, no, I won't. I will. That didn't look good. Okay, but anyway, yeah, what we're gonna ask guys, if you guys would have wanted to see one on the PS2. But what we'll do is we'll get one series done before, we'll get this series done before we start another World Rally Series. We have got WRC 5 Korea. That's gonna continue on, I think, up until WRC 6 comes out, which is, I think it's sometime in October. Or that might actually continue on, you know, during it. I think I might just, yeah, what would you guys want to see with that, with the WRC 5? Let me know in the comments. I'm going to continue it. I've got a few rallies to go, or three rallies to go as I'm recording this. There's three rallies left in that season, but would you guys like to see another season before WRC 6? You know, we can, I bet I could squeeze it in, you know, over throughout August and September. But yeah, focus on this rally, James, what you doing. But yeah, I'm just asking you guys, because you guys are the one that are going to be watching it. I'm the one that's going to be recording and playing it and I'm going to enjoy playing it nonetheless, when I'm recording or not. But if you guys want to see the continued series of WRC 5, you know, or would you want to see a series 2 in the WRC on WRC 5? Because I would like to do a new series, because, well, I'm not going to lie, with how many rallies left, well, I'm not going to spoil note with, well, up to Germany, that one came out the other day, I think we're mathematically out of the championship fight. So I don't know whether you guys would want to see me win a World Rally Championship on there. Let me know. Would you actually want to sit through another season, though? But WRC 6, that's definitely going to be a series on the channel when it comes out. Across the line, 3 in a row, I believe that is. I hope it's 3 in a row, so. Yeah, 8 seconds. Okay, I have been just focusing on what I'm doing here. 2 stages to go, guys, and we nearly 20 seconds ahead. Okay, so stage number 6, I believe this is. Dominating this rally. I didn't expect it to be this easy, to be perfectly honest. I hope the season's not going to be that easy. I don't think it is. It's not going to be this easy. I'm going to have to, for some reason, or somehow, I'm going to have to maybe up the difficulty a little, because I don't really know what it's on, and where can I check it? Sorry about this, guys. I really am sorry. Is it game options? Yeah, opponent's levels. It's on half. And why have I got stability help on? Yeah, so it's on half. I'm going to have to up that in the, for the next video, or for the next, yeah, for the next rally. It's on halfway. I don't really know why it is on half. I'm going to up it a bit because, well, Monte Carlo, that was close as anything. That was a hard rally. I don't get it, but maybe I've just got used to the game within a couple of rallies. It's possible, but that's not going to, yeah, that is risky, but that's not going to help our cause, is it? We've dominated this rally since we took over from Sebastien Ogier, and it looks like, yeah, I'm definitely going to put the difficulty up. I'm not going to have it on maximum. WRC 5, that is on maximum. That's on maximum difficulty. Australia, like I said, in Monte Carlo, that's, if you haven't seen it, it should still be up on the channel, you know. Well, it, of course, it's always going to be up on the channel, but Australia, WRC 5, go check it out. That was a fantastic rally. I'm sure some of you guys that are watching this video now know why I'm saying go check it out, because it is a fantastic rally. I really enjoyed it, and you guys will enjoy watching it too, I'm pretty sure, so, well, I hope you guys will. But yeah, left five, can we jump? Yeah, got a jump here. Can we go over another jump and an even bigger jump? And we landed, and another bit of a bump that was, but I love this car, I love rallying, I just love motorsport in general as well. I keep saying motorsport, I love it, it's brilliant, it helps me relax, it gets me on the edge of my seat, it gets intense, it gets close. We, like in NASCAR, we have so many close finishes. Maybe not in the series I do, but we get so many close finishes in NASCAR. It's unbelievable. Formula One, that's intense, seeing the two Mercedes face each other or race each other. That's as long as nobody's been pushed off the racetrack, of course, by anyone. But we need a bit of, you know, stability in Formula One where teams can compete, have something on the same level. You know, in a way, because Formula One used to be, well, not over the last few years. It's been exciting. We've had some decent drivers, some good races. But across the line for the fourth stage win in a row, yes, we do. And, yeah, it's been very, we have had times before where you've turned up to where there's been Formula One on and you don't know who's going to win. But anyway, we win that stage by 6 seconds, 23 seconds ahead, and we're over half a minute ahead of Sebastien Loeb. The final stage is up next, and there's nothing really betting against us not winning it. It's the final stage of Rally Sweden, and it looks like we're going to be dominating this rally and this, well, yeah, this rally overall, so, well, let's see how we do it, how we can win here. Stage 7, I've got an itchy chest. For some reason, I don't know where that's come from. Sometimes I do get, like, itchy heat sometimes, and it gets warm in here. Especially when you sat here recording with your jumper on, James. That's stupid. But anyway, yes. What was I going to say as well? Dominating rally. Maybe it's because of the difficulties on, you know, halfway. So I'm above average. That's all I'm going to say. At this game, I'm above average so far. So, yes. I hope I can be more than above average. You know, in recent, you know, in next, well, in recent upcoming rallies, get your words out, James. Start, learn how to speak properly. But yes, we hit that barrier. That's not the first time, and it won't be the last. But it's the final stage here in Sweden. Let's hope we can. Well, we, I'm not saying we're not going to win this stage, but I'm not saying we're going to neither, because you can never tell in rallying, as we just, as you do something like that. Well, because, well, you've all seen my rallying videos, haven't you? Should we go this camera? Okay, maybe not that camera, never mind. But yes, you guys have seen all my rally videos before. You guys know how terrible I am at the game, so, or at the games. So, you, well, I've made plenty of mistakes by leading before. Remember Poland? WRC Rally Poland in WRC 5, so, which brings me to another thing, the esports that I've been competing in. That's actually quite fun. I finished 31st this time in Finland out of, was it 180 something? I'm going to have to, I think I got a picture of it on my PS4, so I'll go check. But yeah, I think it was out of 180 something, but anyway. Okay, right. Okay, so we gained some time on Ogier. Are we going to get beaten here and not, you know, get a power stage win? Because, to be fair, in, what's it called, in Rally Sweden, no, Rally Sweden, in WRC 5, we did win a lot of power stages in the early part of the season. 100. Yes, so, over jump, I'm going to go this way so we don't end up, you know, coming close to the barrier when we land there. But we hit the other one. And yes, that was risky and across the line. And we do win that stage. A surprise win, to be fair. That was close. That was close, I would believe. So yes, we win the power stage. Not by much, but we win the power stage. And that's put us on... Well, we win the rally overall. So we win our first rally of the season. I almost didn't say or didn't be happy about that. But yes, let's see... What's that done to... We lead the championship by one single point over Sebastian Loeb. 3 points separate the top three. I hope it's going to be between us three because I would like to be able to fight these two for world championship. And yeah, let's hope it can happen like that. And to be fair, guys, I'm going to see you in the next video. So thank you so much for watching. And until next time... Goodbye.